At Sisense, we think about analytics differently. Instead of requiring users to get out of their workflow to go find data, we believe that actionable intelligence should be infused everywhere people are spending their time. From business applications like CRM or ERP systems to notifications on communication apps like Slack, to driving action within a visualization where a user can automate multiple steps in their processes or workflows by interacting with a visualization within one of their systems. This can also happen within your own products to create stickiness or even help you create new revenue streams. Sisense sees interacting with data as an infusion lifecycle, where you fuse your data and strategy together to build a robust analytics platform that users of all skill levels can use to explore data. On this foundation, you can connect all your data together, analyze it in a code-free or code-driven manner, and augment it with AI and machine learning that powers automatic insights for users or drives deeper exploration of data with forward-looking intelligence. Finally, and perhaps most importantly, is the infuse aspect. Taking a dashboard or a visualization and infusing the actionable intelligence directly into places where people spend their time to make data-driven decisions become a natural part of how people work, so that data adoption is a problem of the past. This extends to your own customers that need data within your own products. The possibilities of the intelligence infusion lifecycle are really limitless. Let's see how this works within the Sisense platform. We can connect to data of all sizes and from all locations, starting with cloud data warehouses that you can connect to in real time. You can even push down compute to these warehouses to leverage the power of the cloud. Looking into our existing data, we can add new views or edit existing views of our data. This opens a SQL development environment where you can write a query directly on the data warehouse, pull data, and perform manipulations using SQL, and then simply view the output below. We can profile the data to instantly validate and encourage faster exploration. We can schedule the data to materialize or update at intervals of our choosing, which will load and update our analytics. You can combine all your data sources from on-prem to cloud to flat files together in a cached way within Sisense or live on those cloud data sources. Choosing a live model is ideal when you have that cloud data warehouse such as Redshift or Snowflake to leverage the power of the cloud to run large-scale queries in an efficient and fast way. We're going to look at an ElastiCube model, which is a cached model that will allow us to use multiple different data sources. We can add custom logic, dimensions, and measures to our datasets to add different features, from math to text to a variety of options. You can preview your data at any time and can simply drag and drop your data sources together to join them in a smart way through establishing relationships. Once you have your data together, you can simply click Build to use as your complete data source to analyze your data and build visualizations from. When you're ready to build a visualization, you can start by selecting your data to start your analysis on. You have a blank slate to work off of, where you can add widgets that tell your data story in exactly the way that you need. Simply start adding data variables available from your dataset, and then choose the type of visualization that will help you effectively communicate each insight. From indicators to sunbursts to polar charts to tree maps and so much more, you have the visualizations to truly craft a compelling analysis. You can customize the experience, adding the right layers of information. You can change colors, change fonts, add filters to truly empower users to get the information that they need. Once you've created the widgets that you want, you can drag and drop them to end up with something that encompasses the unique look and feel that will help others get the most out of the analysis. Let's look at a pre-built dashboard that analyzes discussions on Stack Overflow, the top developer community where users come to post questions and have discussions about various technologies. Looking at the dashboard, it may just seem like another dashboard, but the interactivity that happens between the visualizations inside Sisense is where this dashboard becomes especially powerful. For example, if I select a dimension like JavaScript on my post by code language pie chart, it's automatically going to update the rest of the visualizations on the dashboard to that specific dimension. I can also dig deeper. Simply right-clicking on California will allow me to jump directly into my data model and select another dimension that I can break this down by. I might want to break it up by city to get deeper. Once I do so, I can simply right-click to go deeper by each city into individual zip codes. This allows anyone to start with a very high-level concept and become more and more granular as I interact and explore my data and to get that answer to my very specific question. All of the visualizations here are working together to tell a story. Looking at the post growth rate, it shows 89.4%. That's not telling me a whole lot by itself, but I can click into that to get more context. On the right side, there is robust text leveraging AI-powered narratives through natural language generation. This is automatically pulling out key insights and puts them in text for anyone to understand what is going on in the data. For example, it tells me that the coding language Ruby had the largest decline over other coding languages, which might be immediately hard to see in the visualizations themselves. This is all dynamic as well, so if we dive into JavaScript, it highlights just the insights for JavaScript. This is an incredibly powerful tool for those that may not have as much data expertise or as a way to jumpstart any deeper data exploration. Going back to our dashboard, we can click into user growth rate to see more details on why user growth rate decreased. By simply clicking on a state, the map will zoom in automatically to show me that specific region, and I can start exploring without needing deep data expertise. Let's dive into the third, the posts per user. This unique data experience allows us to jump into specific user profiles or can move between users to see their specific information. One of the most exciting aspects of Sisense is to actually take action directly from a visualization. A visualization that could be directly in a CRM or ERP system, so you're not having to jump between applications in order to take these actions. I can simply send a message directly to Stack Overflow from the visualization. The opportunities of the actions are limitless for your workflows and processes. Another unique way for users to interact with data is through AI-powered Simply Ask. Any user can ask a question just as they would type a question into any search engine. By searching for posts in a city like Seattle, we can get a clear and quick answer without having to dig around a dashboard. We can also ask forward-looking questions to see how many posts are predicted to happen, leveraging built-in predictive analytics. Our AI doesn't stop there. With explanations, a user can dig deeper into the data to understand the reasons and impacts behind any data point simply by just clicking their mouse. In this example, Sisense provides combinations of different variables to explain why the posts may have decreased for a specific period of time. And for even deeper predictive analytics, we can embed code-driven data science into any dashboard for users of all skill levels to leverage. Let's look under the hood of this powerful data science section. We see the four charts from the data science section and another model to compare them. These were built by users that love the customization and flexibility of coding languages like R, Python, or SQL. Let's see the code in the IDE behind this. We can select different cloud data warehouses if we wanted, and we can see the tables and schemas very clearly within Sisense. Looking at the simple SQL query, we can easily make changes and view the data profile of that query to instantly validate our data. We could just use this data as an output, but the real value comes when you use Python or R on top of it. We have our R notebook, which we could have started from scratch or jump-started with a template that will get us about 95% of the way that we can then manipulate for our exact analysis. Sisense has built-in libraries that you can load in other libraries or custom modules to ensure your analysis is exactly what you need. Again, we can see a preview of our output and the immediate statistics of our data. Going back to our models, we can look through at the comparison to choose which one we want to productionize to our users who may not understand the code behind the scenes. We can simply materialize it back as a table in our cloud data warehouse, and we can also share this across all use cases. The power of Sisense goes beyond the dashboard, as our mission is to infuse analytics everywhere. As we showed earlier, you can embed action into any part of a visualization so that multiple steps in a workflow can be automated for users, such as sending that message in Stack Overflow, or they could interact with their CRM to make updates or schedule a meeting. Infusing analytics into workflows, processes, business applications, or even your own products is because we are an API-first platform, and we are highly extensible. We have an embedded playground to experience the art of the possible. Regardless of whether you are embedding analytics for your internal use case to help solve for adoption by putting actionable intelligence directly where people work, or are embedding analytics into your own products to drive new revenue streams, increase customer stickiness, or use analytics to empower your own end customers for their own data-driven decisions, we make it easy in the Sisense platform. The most simplistic way is to use an iframe. This takes your entire dashboard and embeds it anywhere. Next is to expand those iframe capabilities a bit with our embed SDK. This leverages the iframe type dashboard, but you can programmatically control the settings of the dashboard. Finally, you can leverage Sisense JS, which allows you to break up a dashboard into different component pieces and embed those individual components natively into an application or web page using JavaScript and have them live as JavaScript elements, which provides a ton of flexibility. You have full control over colors and can change them with a simple click. You can change fonts, white label with your logo to truly create that truly custom experience with the look and feel to make it your own brand. At Sisense, we want to help you infuse analytics wherever you need them, from business applications, workflows, processes, and your own products. We can help accelerate your time to value.